Innocence often hides the malevolent, the wicked, the evil. Organizations will ill-intent meet to decide the fate of billions of innocent individuals in the name of the greater good. Such information is dangerous to those outside these circles. Proceed with caution. You have been warned, Nunc Trugavertir.
Swannanoa is a beautiful mansion that sits atop Afton Mountain, Virginia. It has seen a lot of history over the years, while also being the location of many conspiracy theories involving the paranormal and even the Illuminati. Today, let's take a look at the story of Swannanoa, try and figure out what is fact and what is fiction. Swannanoa is an Italian Renaissance revival villa built in 1912 by millionaire James Dooley. He based the house on buildings in the Villa Medici in Rome. The house was intended to be a summer retreat for James and his wife Sally Mae, and is said to have taken over 300 artisans 8 years to build the home. Built as a token of love from husband to wife, the depth of James and Sally Mae's relationship was represented in the 4,000-piece Tiffany stained glass window and a domed ceiling bearing the likeness of Miss Dooley. And the house was built out of Georgian marble that was imported directly from Italy. James Dooley died in 1924 and left the house to his wife, but she died in 1926, and the home was deeded to Dooley's sisters, who sold Swannanoa in 1926 to the Valley Corporation of Richmond, which became the second owner of Swannanoa. They planned and opened a country club in 1929 and closed in 1932. The United States Navy considered purchasing and renovating the property in 1942, which they calculated would cost $200,000 for the purpose of establishing a secret facility to interrogate prisoners of war. The military rejected it in favor of a Civilian Conservation Corps camp in Fort Hunt, Virginia, codenamed P.O. Box 111-42, because it seemed unlikely that Congress would approve the purchase of such a palatial state for the purpose. The mansion stood empty throughout the Great Depression and World War II until it was leased in 1949 to Walter Russell for his University of Science and Philosophy. Walter Russell was born on May 19, 1871 in Boston, Massachusetts, and was known as the most versatile man in America at the time of his death. His lectures and writings place him firmly in the New Thought movement. At age 9, he left school to build a life for himself, and he managed to make enough money to put himself through art school, where he became a noted painter and sculptor. In the 1930s, Russell was employed by Thomas J. Watson, who was a chairman of IBM, as a motivational speaker for IBM employees. One of the employees later wrote, "I consider Walter Russell's talk last night one of the finest I have ever heard. His informal talk on personal power created a burning desire within us to make greater use of the personal power we possess. Every man present is a better man as a result of hearing this inspiring message." He was employed at IBM for 12 years, during which time he and Watson developed a new concept of utilitarian business ethics. In May 1921, Russell claimed to have experienced a transformational, revelatory event that he later described in a chapter called The Story of My Illumining in the 1950 edition of his home study course. "During that period, I could perceive all motion and was newly aware of all things." He later wrote, "It will be remembered that no one who has ever had the experience of illumination has been able to explain it. I deem it my duty to let the world be known of this information." Russell's supposed knowledge gained in the light is the subject matter of his book, The Divine Iliad, published in two volumes in 1948 and 1949. The Russell cosmogony was described in his trilogy as a new concept of the universe, where he wrote that the cardinal error of science is shutting the creator out of his creation. Russell never referred to a single God, but rather wrote that God is the invisible, motionless, sexless, undivided, and unconditional white magnetic light of mind, which centers all things. God is provable by laboratory results, Russell wrote. The locatable, motionless light which man calls magnetism is the light which God is. He wrote that religion and science must come together in a new age. In 1948, Walter, at age 77, divorced his first wife and married Daisy Stebbing at age 44, amid some controversy. She changed her name to Lao after Lao Tzu, and they crossed the country looking for a sanctuary to house their ideas and spiritual temple. They eventually chose Swannanoa. There they established the museum and the Walter Russell Foundation, and in 1957 the Commonwealth of Virginia granted a charter for the University of Science and Philosophy, a correspondence school with a home study course. Walter and Lyle Russell collaborated on a number of books. The testing of atomic bombs in the atmosphere prompted them to publish Atomic Suicide in 1957, in which they warned of grave consequences for the planet and for humankind if radioactivity was exploited as a world fuel. His theories were very similar to those of the Illuminati, and Swannanoa features owl statues in the ceiling of the main staircase, and some people even say that Swannanoa was the meeting site for Illuminati members and was visited by the Queen of England, Ted Kennedy, Henry Kissinger, Pope John Paul III, Margaret Thatcher, and many other people with alleged ties to secret organizations. Walter Russell died in 1963, and Lyle died in 1988. There's a lot more to the story of the Russells and their time at Swannanoa, but for this video I'm only highlighting the main points to give you an idea of what was occurring and what has been said to have happened at Swannanoa. It is said that Afton Mountain, where Swannanoa is, holds dark energy that even the Native Americans spoke about. UFOs are seen there often. A lot of murder occurs on the mountain, and there is even a local legend about the Waynesboro Wendigo, or the Waynesboro Bigfoot, that is seen on Afton Mountain. So it's no surprise to hear that rituals were held at Swannanoa. A group called Starborn held its 11/11 doorway opening ritual there in 2012. Their goal was to open a doorway or bridge between our world of duality and the greater reality. From what I could find about this ritual, it was attended by people that were very wealthy and contained a lot of Egyptian symbolism, while the group seemed to dabble in mind control techniques. For a location with so much conspiracy around it, you would think it'd be home to plenty of spirits, but strangely this is not the case for Swannanoa. Although no full investigation has ever been held on the grounds, there have been people that have done EVP sessions that have recorded some very strange responses, and there also have been many strange photos taken at Swannanoa. Sally Dooley is said to roam the house, and people have seen her walking around, heard her voice, and have reported the smell of perfume in the lower levels of the home. Some people also say former servants haunt the home, and one group that spent a few hours doing EVP sessions in the home reported feeling uneasy at certain times, and some members even became sick during the sessions. I have always been interested in Swannanoa since I moved to the area in 2010, but I didn't visit the palace until September of 2019, and when I went, I knew next to nothing about the home. I knew it was built in 1912, some people had died in the home, and that it was very beautiful. As I walked the grounds, I was kind of let down to feel almost no spiritual energy until I walked into one room in the back lower levels that looked just like a psychosomatum. These rooms use mirrors and sometimes light to guide spirits from their dimensions into our world so they can interact with us. And as I mentioned this to a friend, one of the staff members quickly rushed in and moved the mirror, telling me these things don't exist. I was also told that she had been presented many, as in over 20 photos, people had taken of a certain window that looked like someone was standing there, even though no one is allowed on the third floor. She told me these were obviously fake because no one's allowed to be up there. I decided to keep my mentioning of spirits to a minimum, but every time I would mention spirits or odd energy, I would be reminded by a staff member that they didn't exist and that the people who claimed to experience things there were just letting their imaginations get the best of them. The house and grounds have a lot of strange symbols that didn't look pagan, satanic, or otherwise occultic, but they struck me as medieval, mainly because there are a lot of murals of knights and medieval imagery in the home and on the grounds. I've always heard that when you become aware of spirits and certain energies, they will make themselves known to you, and that's exactly what happened at Swannanoa. As I started to silently piece together that something wasn't right, I found myself feeling watched and followed everywhere I went. Someone or something didn't like that I knew what I knew, and at this time I wasn't aware of the Russells' work and alleged ties to the Illuminati, or the rituals that were held there, and the ones that were actually held there. I look forward to my next visit to Swannanoa like a child looks forward to Christmas morning, and I have a sneaky suspicion something strange will happen. There is a lot of local legend, a lot of conspiracy theories, and a lot of stories about Swannanoa. As for whether or not they are true or whether they are fiction, we may never know. I can't wait until I go back, because now I have the information that I have, I'll be more aware to look for certain symbols that may stick out. Have you ever heard of the Swannanoa Palace, and if yes, what have you heard about it? Based on the information I presented in this video, what do you think is going on not just at Swannanoa, but on Afton Mountain? Thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to leave a like if you enjoy the video and subscribe for more videos. From Fife Paranormal, I'm Jake Fife. Thank you for listening, and have a great day.